Meghan Markle takes her royal patronages very seriously, and this week she celebrated the incredible success the charity SmartWorks has been having since her involvement was announced. Apparently, the Duchess of Sussex's impact on the organization has already been evident, with the charity helping almost 50% more women in February 2019 than it did in the same month in 2018. Royal commentator Ahmed Scobby revealed on Twitter, still busy. Duchess Meghan this morning attended a meeting with SmartWorks at St. Charles Hospital. The charity has been growing rapidly since Meghan became patron. In February they helped 187 women in London alone, 47% more than this time last year. In January 2019, when Meghan's first royal patronages were announced, the Duchess visited SmartWorks. Meghan's secret visit to SmartWorks this week celebrates the charity's incredible work and extended reach, helping even more women in the process. No rest for the royals. Meghan Markle spent her Friday morning at a secret meeting with one of her patronages, SmartWorks, royal reporter Ahmed Scobby confirmed in a tweet last night. The Duchess of Sussex had a meeting with the charity's CEO, Kate Stevens, but it was a private meeting, which means that Meghan might be finished with public outings in the weeks leading up to the royal baby's birth. Meghan has made clear that SmartWorks, and its mission to help unemployed women prepare for the working world, is close to her heart. As any royal fan is aware, Meghan is inching closer to her due date and, per Hello, is not expected to make any more public outings before the birth of the baby. Reportedly, Meghan's goal was to meet with each patronage privately before going on maternity leave. Prince Harry might have also hinted that Meghan's maternity leave is underway when he visited St. Vincent's Catholic Primary School on Wednesday. One child asked Harry where Meghan was, and he made the motion of a pregnant stomach and told the student that she was having a baby. Throughout her pregnancy, Meghan Markle has teased when the royal baby is due to arrive. During an official visit in January 2019, Meghan hinted that she's due at the end of April, meaning that the royal family could have a new addition very soon. And according to People, Meghan's Californian roots are already influencing the Duchess' pregnancy, and how she wants to raise the royal baby. A friend of the Duchess of Sussex allegedly told People, Meghan's California roots are coming through. She's being mindful of what she puts in her body and on her skin and even her at-home cleaning supplies. She's hyper-aware of what she's using. She's looking for natural things. While the Duchess of Sussex is already well known for her healthy lifestyle, People's source explained that pregnancy has only made her healthier, she eats cleaner, and she'll probably make her own baby food. It's going to be clean living for this baby. Meghan and Harry are, of course, leaving Kensington Palace for their new residence in Windsor at Frogmore Cottage. The building has been renovated to the couple's specifications, just in time for their new little arrival. It is thought that Meghan intended to meet with each organization privately, before she winds down to prepare for the birth. The Duchess has kept herself pretty busy despite approaching the end of her first pregnancy, with overseas trips to New York and Morocco and a number of other official engagements during her final trimester. Meghan is not expected to make any more public outings, and her recent meetings behind closed doors could reveal that she is now in fact on maternity leave, having visited each patronage. Prince Harry even hinted that Meghan is officially taking a much-needed break during his visit to St. Vincent's Catholic Primary School on Wednesday. As Harry met pupils in the playground, one asked him where Meghan was. Harry responded by miming his wife's baby bump with his hand, and telling them she was having a baby, suggesting that she's now officially on leave. The royal couple's last public appearance together was an unplanned engagement at New Zealand House in London, to pay tribute to the victims of last week's devastating attack.